So inside, in the gym, when a hole is broken, when it's dirty, it's easy to change it. Just a drill, it takes a few seconds and it doesn't matter, it's the way of the gym. I think outside it's totally different. When a hole is broken, it's done. And better to wait and to think by ourselves what to do. I think we have a way to educate people about cleaning the shoes. And anyway, there are mats, no sand. After for the choke, it's a kind of education, but outside there's nobody to educate anybody. So it's better to be responsible of what we are doing and enjoy the climbing and think to the other climbers and the other people around you.
We should be aware of these places. They are all great places, quite fragile, like here you can see the whole impact from erosion and everything, and we should be aware of that. And it's true that it could be a problem for a young guy starting climbing in a climbing wall, having no interaction with nature, and the first time he will come outside climbing, he want to climb, just crank hard, do hard problem, so. But that's not just that, it's part of it, but we have to be respectful with these places.
Like, here's a great example of what climbers have caused in this area, because all this damage here on the ground is caused by climbers. And it's gotten to the point where all these blocks, like the whole big four, they're just gonna fall over the entire boulder because of the ground has eroded so much.
So to help the whole climbing community, it would be great if everyone looks for the area he's climbing in, and also to spread the word, like look what other climbers are doing and tell them, maybe help them.
Yeah, like most people, they don't understand that they actually have an impact when they go out bouldering, but right here, all this is caused just by climbers. So we all do have a little impact, and when that totals, it's quite a lot, so we all have to take our part to like, yeah, try to minimize it at least.
James Taylor from Cardiff, and no wild camping, guys.
Or else!